another video, and today we're going to be looking at atomic structure. In our previous video, we saw that the chemical world is made out of atoms, and we remember that the atom has two main parts. It has a central nucleus, and it has electrons that are orbiting the nucleus. You guys need to know the charges of the subatomic particles that make up the atom. When inside of our nucleus, we have protons. Protons are subatomic particles with a positive charge, a plus one charge. Inside the nucleus, we also have a subatomic particle called neutrons. Neutrons have no charge, they're electrically neutral. The electrons that orbit the nucleus have a minus one charge, they're negatively charged. We must remember at all times that atoms are overall neutrally charged. And the reason why an atom has a neutral charge is because the number of protons, or the number of positive charges, are always the same as the number of electrons, the negative charges. So let's have a look a bit closer at some more atomic structure. Remember from our previous video, we said that the periodic table is built of elements. Let's look at one of those elements as an example. Now I'm going to look at lithium. Lithium has the chemical symbol Li. And lithium has got two numbers attached to it. These two numbers act as like a signature for lithium. Well, this number at the bottom, the three, this is called the atomic number. It's also known as the proton number, or the number of protons. So, lithium has three protons. From our previous slide, you should remember that if it's got three protons, then lithium must also have three electrons, as lithium, the atom, is neutral. This top number, the number at the top, this is called the mass number. The mass number is the number of protons added to the number of neutrons. So if we add protons and neutrons together, we get the mass number. You could be asked in your exam to calculate proton, neutron, or electron numbers. Let me use lithium as an example. The P stands for proton, N stands for neutron, and E stands for electron. So, looking at lithium, you should be able to calculate the proton number. Well, that's simple because that's the number at the bottom. So the proton number is three. We already know that if an element has three protons, it also has three electrons because the charges need to cancel. But how would we calculate the number of neutrons? Well, in this example, what we would need to do is the mass number, which is the number at the top, and we would minus the atomic number, which is the number at the bottom. So the number of neutrons for lithium is simply 7 take away 3, which gives us a neutron number of 4. Okay guys, thanks for tuning in. Stay in touch for another video.